Hey everybody, welcome to another video. I know I said I don't going to say hello and goodbye and all that stuff in every single video of a recording session, but with ATS and ETS2 it is going to be exactly like that again, because I will record one trip and then I will stop the recording, save the video and stuff, and then we'll start recording the next trip. So I am going to say hello and goodbye on every video for ATS and upcoming videos of ETS2. So again, welcome. We are going from Flagstaff to Hobbs with a trailer full of fireworks. So, and yeah, it is kinda tricky because my I don't have much space on my desk with all the button box, the shifter, and my keyboard and the wheel and the microphone and my vape, and also I need to drink, so I have my Coke standing around here. But anyways, let's go for it. And guys, I play this with a manual transmission and with shifter, of course, when I play manual transmission. And I also forgot to set my multi-monitor settings back to single monitor, because usually when I play off camera, when I play just for myself, I play with a I drive on three monitors, on three screens. But yeah, I forgot to set it back, and right now I actually pretty much don't care about it. Yeah, I know that I start in my the seventh gear. But hey, no one is perfect, right? Maybe on the next stop I should get rid of that stone guard. Oh, and yeah, sure. And we drive in the Freightliner Argosy that I mod, that I just downloaded from the Steam Workshop. I really like it, and the strange right mirror that you see on top of your screen. This mirror settings came with the Argosy mod, so yeah, I don't like it that much. But because I forgot to set my multi-mon settings back, I have to use the on-screen mirrors. Come on, move over. Let me flash in. And I totally do not care about speed limits, and I What means I don't care. I try to stick to them every now and then. And yeah, this is a modded save game with modded money and a modded level because, just because I wanted to. It's actually that easy. But you're going 65 in a 75-mile zone, so move the fuck over. If you are an impatient person, trucking is maybe not your kind of a job. Okay, let's go back down to 75 and hit the cruise control. If I would know any country songs, I would start singing it for you guys. This is not ETS2, so I have to s I haven't to I don't have to switch lanes for an exit lane to avoid an exit lane. Look at this beautiful. Nope, don't you dare. Just took a picture. And I am glad that it is 6 a.m. so the sun is getting up and we don't have to ride in the dark. Because I'm kinda far away from my screen. And, as you might know or not, my eyes aren't the best, so. Control memory button. Still can't remember my button setup by head, so I always have to look down to find all the buttons I need, or the switches, not just the buttons. I can barely see the car that is driving in front of me. Shifting isn't that bad, actually. £51,400. I know I shouldn't start in a seventh gear. Manual with a G29 shifter is so much fun. Hit the cruise control again. I hope my mic is not too quiet. It sounds good for me, but you never know. Oh, it's actually. Well, as you can see, I do care about the speed limit to keep it at least a little bit realistic, because this is not a race game. And yeah, this is also pretty much the reason why I don't play multiplayer anymore. Because the people on the server, most of them are just, yep, idiots who don't give a shit about rules and just going like 150 miles in the city with a truck. So yeah. Now I keep my lights on, because otherwise I can't see my gorgeous. Is it got dials? I think it's dials, right? I'm not sure about that. No, I was about to say, give me a few suggestions, what are, you know exactly what I'm talking about, why you're still asking, what truck you wanna see me drive in the next video, but I'm going to record the 4 tours straight before the first video even will be uploaded. But you still can post it if you want, and I will have a look at it. edit is look at edit. Pretty hard to say for a German guy. And yeah, I will check it and see if I can drive the suggested truck in the next recording session. So that means from this video on, the not even from this video on, the fifth video that is coming up. Of ATS will be then with the truck you suggested. Fuck it. Come on, let me get over. I know it's 75 again, but I stick to 65. It's more comfortable to get a little bit slower. Switch lanes. Oh, and by the way, I am using the coast to coast and Canada map. If you guys wonder why the map is that big. It was for me at the first time kind of tricky to get the coast to coast and Canadream both running, because they have in a specific priority to actually run. They will show up if you don't do it correctly. They will show up anyways on the map, but you have little cuts between those modded streets or modded areas, so you can go up there in this direction, but you actually can't get on the streets, on the roads that are coming with this mods, because there is a gap. You can also see then on the map that there are parts of the streets and roads are missing. So yeah, you have to put both of them at the very top of the priority list. Otherwise they will not work. Even also skins or trucks or tuning add-ons or whatever you add to the game have to be low. This both map mods, otherwise they don't work properly. Guys, I'm also thinking about for the next recording session to use two cameras, one like you see it right now, as a face cam. That will be the one that is permanently connected to my screen. Even if I want to use that camera for a second cam, I can't, because I have this wire hoses everywhere so the wires don't go wild. But I have a way to use my smartphone actually as a PC cam, and I was thinking about place it somewhere behind me and above me, and that basically shows wheel slash button box view also. Let me know, guys, if you wanna see it like that for the next recording session. Then, like I said before, it will be the 5th ATS video will be the next recording session. Okay, what now? I need to get a bit closer, because my arms are not long enough to reach the shifter when I sit that far back. Still have to get used to the shifter. I don't know how many gearboxes I have screwed up in this game since I'm using manual shifting. I have a lot of damage to it anyways, and that is what I know. Every time I made, I don't know, a couple tours, I had to repair my gearbox. Yeah, you are amazing, Mr. Regina. Thank you very much. Yeah, this blinker left right left thing is how truckers in Germany say thank you. also don't know how realistic it is to jump in gears like I do it. No idea. But going from single gear to gear is, it just takes me too long, so I jump in gears. What? 90, 190 miles left. Will be longer than 30 minutes. The video, I mean. Again, where is this shit? Oh, right in front of me. Okay. Well, thank you, buddy.